like to travel. So today we're going to talk about bags, lots and lots of bags. So different airlines will offer you different baggage options. Airline carriers such as Spirit and Frontier will offer you something that's called a personal item, and that is just a backpack like this, this size, something easy to carry, anything that can fit underneath the seat in front of you, or a small purse like this one. Like I said, anything that can fit under the seat in front of you is what you are allowed. Spirit's motto is all you pay for is your and gas. So because they're not charging you for some fictitious piece of luggage that you may or may not take on the flight, they are saving you money. So any sort of airline that is cheap is going to only offer you a personal item. Of course, you can always pay for a carry-on or a checked bag. I believe the checked bag is $5 cheaper than the carry-on at Spirit. Bigger carriers such as American and United will offer something like this for free. Now this is your carry-on. The dimensions of this one are going to be 22 by 14 by 9. So I know those are the dimensions that American allows you. I'm not sure what United allows you off the top of my head, but this is my go-to guy when I am traveling. He fits really good in the overhead bin. It's a little bit squishy on the side, but it's still pretty durable. The other option is to have a duffel bag. Now, a duffel bag like this, which is pretty much the same size as this suitcase, but it's squishy on the side, so you can fit more in there. So if you're trying to get the most out of your space, I would recommend a soft-sided duffel bag. And the other thing too about carrying your bags, like a backpack or a duffel bag like this, is you're not going to get stopped as much, because they figure if you can carry it, then it'll fit on the plane. They don't have to stop you. They won't measure you. Then the other option is this big one here. This is going to be your checked bag. I know in my last video I mentioned how to check in. This is the bag that you're going to give when you check in. This is the one that has to be weighed. So when you check in and you have a checked bag like this, this is the one that you will give in. It's bigger than that one. I'm not sure the dimensions of this, but anything bigger than the 22 by 14 by 9 is going to be a checked bag. Sometimes when you're flying international, your carrier will allow you to have a free checked bag plus a free carry-on plus a free personal item, because they figure you're paying enough for the ticket anyway. This is where you will have the least amount of restrictions. This is where your full-size shampoos, conditioners, liquids, gels, aerosols, everything that you cannot take with you in this guy will go in this guy, because this one is going on the plane underneath the cabin, and you will not have access to it. This one you will have access to. This one goes in the overhead bin above your seat. So obviously the airlines don't want you to bring anything dangerous in this one. Obviously, they don't want you to take anything dangerous in this one either. Your personal item can also be a laptop bag or a briefcase. Garment bags are considered carry-ons because most of the time they are about this size. Whether you fold them over, they still do want you to put them in the overhead bin. As long as they're smaller, if they're about personal item size, then you might be okay. So as I mentioned, sometimes this one will incur some fees. This one depends on weight. If it's under a certain weight, then it's going to be cheaper. Or like I said, if you're flying international, it's going to be free. This one is free as long as it fits in their sizing device. As far as these backpacks go, they don't necessarily weigh them. And the one thing you want to keep in mind is they don't weigh them at security. They will let you go through security and get to your gate, and if at the gate you get stopped and they say your bag is too big, then you'll have to pay a fee there. And usually the at-the-gate fees are going to be exponentially high. So you're going to want to make sure that this or this or this abides by all of your restrictions before you even get to the airport, so you're not charged more. I think that's it. So that's it. I don't think I have anything else to say on bags or baggage. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below, and I will answer them to the best of my ability. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.